what is important is to have new programs for educating students at various levels, starting from the undergraduate level up to the PhD level. And these require that students know computer science, they need to know statistics, plus they need to know something about some area in more detail. And that kind of a combination of knowledge is needed. For applying artificial intelligence, being very narrow is not useful. You need to have a broad background. And this needs to be encouraged through the educational system. So I think education is the most important one at the various levels. Then for people who are already working in industry, it has to be done in a different way. There you need some method for continuing education. Maybe it is by taking online courses, things like that, by which they can catch up on this kind of training, which when they went to school or college, they did not study. But you need to do continuing education. Advances in productivity come from applying modern techniques in every area. So these can apply here as well as anywhere else. So for example, I don't know, let's take the example of fishing. If you want to keep track of the state of fishing, what is happening over time and over space, that requires a certain kind of reasoning process, which fits in very much into geographical information systems combined with artificial intelligence type of techniques. I think what is important is that the big change has to be both in universities and in companies, which is that to be alert to the new opportunities and to invest in them. It is that is what is important. So you need to know that this field is coming up. Train the scientists, train the engineers, train the managers. I think that this particular meeting that we have is of course a step in the right direction for that. Again, the main thing is that the government should have a policy which deals with what is to be done. And this has to have many, many components. Education at the school and college level, funding of research, as well as continuing education for people who are currently in industry. I think you need all of these. Because if you just wait for school, the education system in school and colleges, by the time these people graduate and are working in industry, it might be 20 years. So you need to provide this continuing education to people who are already in industry. But you need to change the system in schools and colleges as well to accommodate for this education. And things are moving very fast. So you generally need often many systems are very conservative. So in universities, we don't change our course structure very quickly. We often are teaching the same material which was important 20 years ago. So this innovation, we normally say that we tell industry, oh, you must be innovative. But actually, we academics also need to be innovative.